Hello students, welcome to AKR chemistry classes. In the last class of alcohols, I taught you how to convert carbonyl compounds into respective alcohols by using suitable reducing agent. These are the reducing agents we have been used: lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, boron in presence of tetrahydrofuran, hydrogen in presence of nickel, platinum or palladium catalyst, sodium in presence of ethanol. First, we will revise everything what we have learnt in the last class. Then we will move further. So, lithium aluminium hydride is a strong reducing agent. Lithium aluminium hydride is a strong reducing agent. It is a strong reducing agent which easily reduces aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids, esters, acid anhydrides, everything into respective alcohols. So lithium aluminium hydride has an ability to reduce aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acid, esters and acid anhydrides into respective alcohols. Note it down. Next, coming to sodium borohydride. Sodium borohydride is a weak reducing agent compared to lithium aluminium hydride. The reason I have given in the last video, you can watch the last video to understand why sodium borohydride acts as a weak reducing agent when compared to lithium aluminium hydride. The sodium borohydride can reduce aldehydes, ketones, acid chlorides into respective alcohols. Then coming to boron in presence of tetrahydrofuran, or we can also write it as, in certain books again, also diborane. These are also acts as a strong reducing agent, and they acts as similar lithium aluminium hydride, means they shows the reducing property like lithium aluminium hydride, means which reduces aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acid, esters and acid anhydrides. Coming to next, hydrogen by using nickel, platinum or palladium catalyst, catalytic hydrogenation also. It also acts as a strong reducing agent, which can reduce us again carbonyl compounds, that is aldehydes, ketones, esters, everything into respective alcohols. Then sodium in presence of alcohol also acts as a suitable reducing agent. It also acts as a suitable reducing agent which reduces aldehyde, ketone, ester into respective alcohols. So these are the functional group compounds which can be converted into respective alcohols by using these suitable reducing agent. So this concept I already taught with respect to mechanism in the last video. Still, if you find any difficult, please go through that video before you start the problems. Okay, now note down the problems, pause the video and try to solve it. Coming to first one. In this case, we got aldehyde as a functional group and we got double bond in the carbon chain. Neither lithium aluminium hydride nor sodium hydride has an ability to convert the double bond into single bond, but both reduces aldehydes into respective primary alcohols. Therefore, what is the product we get? CH3CH double bond CH CH2OH. This is the product. If I use hydrogen in presence of nickel catalyst, hydrogen is the strongest reducing agent. It not only reduces aldehydes, but it also reduces the unsaturated hydrocarbon into saturated hydrocarbon. You get CH3, CH2, single bond CH2, CH2OH. Again, carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid get converted into alcohol by using lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. Since it is present in terminal position, therefore we get primary alcohol. But the double bond which is present in the given organic chain, neither reduced by lithium aluminium hydride nor reduced by sodium borohydride. Therefore the product is CH3CH double bond CH CH2OH. But hydrogen in presence of nickel catalyst has an ability to reduce both carboxylic acid group as well as double bond. We get the compound like this, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Please note it down. Okay students, the question is very simple. I have given a molecule. Now what happens, this compound untreated with lithium aluminium hydride as well as sodium hydride. We get the terminal position aldehyde. The terminal position aldehyde is get converted into the terminal position, or if you take like this, CH3. Now it is a ketone. Think this is a ketone. We know that ketone always get reduced to secondary alcohol. Ketones always get converted into secondary alcohol. So I will write like this. Double bond. CH, CH, CH2, CH, OH, CH3. This is a compound we get. Now what happens to the double bond? We untreated with lithium aluminium hydride as well as sodium borohydride, means this double bonded carbon atom is bonded to sp2 carbon atom of phenyl group. And I given the information that if the double bonded in the given carbon chain, if the double bond is bonded to the adjacent carbon atom of phenyl group, then it also undergo a reduction reaction. Therefore we get CH2CH2. So in this case also it is same. Okay, good. Now next question. What happened, this compound untreated with sodium borohydride? Solve it. Very simple question I have given. So we got CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CHO, and CHO is present in the aldehyde group. We know that sodium borohydride is a weak reducing agent, but it reduces aldehydes into respective alcohols. So what is the compound we get? CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2OH. Okay. Now in this case, this is the ester group, RCOO. Ester group cannot be reduced by sodium borohydride, but sodium borohydride has an ability to reduce the ketone group. We got two groups. One is ketone group, another is ester group. Ester group can be reduced by sodium borohydride, but keto group cannot be reduced by, keto group can be reduced by sodium borohydride, but not ester group. So what is the product we get? The keto group is get converted into secondary alcohol. Now the remaining part, CH2C double bond O, O C2H5. Okay, when it is treated with lithium aluminium hydride, when the same compound is treated with lithium aluminium hydride, lithium aluminium hydride not only reduces the ketone group, it also reduces the ester group into respective alcohol. Here the bond get break up to form the compound like this, OH CH2 CH2 OH plus C2H5 OH. Okay, clear? Note it down. Next, answer the fifth question. Pause the video and answer the sixth question. So now we got double bond in a ring structure. We got a keto group here, keto group, and we got an ester group. Now the question is, if I use lithium aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride reduce both keto group and ester group, but not double bond. We know that it never reduces the double bond. Then write down the structure. This double bond remains same. This becomes OH, CH2, CH2OH. Here the bond breaks, we get C2H5OH. Ethanol is obtained. With respect to sodium borohydride neither reduces ester nor reduces double bond, but it easily reduces the ketone. So we get this product, double bond OH CH2COOC2H5. But if it is treated with hydrogen in presence of nickel, platinum or palladium catalyst, it not only reduces ester group, it also reduces ketone as well as unsaturated to saturated. OH CH2CH2OH plus C2H5OH. Now this is the next question. Solve this question. Pause the video. Write down the question on a paper and try to solve it. Now what are the groups they have given? This is the keto group. And this is the acid group. Sodium borohydride can reduce only keto group but not acid group. You can check it. Revise the video and check it. So what be the answer we get? Double bond, double bond, double bond. CH3. This is OH. Acid group remains same. If I use lithium aluminium hydride or this compound, it not only reduces ketone group, it also reduces carboxylic acid into alcohols. OH, CH3, CH2, OH. So, for our next question. Complete the reaction. Keto group get converted into secondary alcohol. And double bond get reduces to single bond. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are get converted into saturated hydrocarbon. Now coming to the last problem. Try to solve this. This is aldehyde group. This is aldehyde. You should have to know which are the groups we have been linked to the given cyclic chain. This is ester group. And this is keto group. Okay students, I think you can solve this problem. So B2H6R we can use like this, BH3 in presence of tetrahydrofuran. It not only reduces aldehyde, it reduces ketone and also reduces ester. So what is the major product we get? Aldehyde is reduced to alcohol, CH2OH. Ketones also get reduces secondary alcohols, ester. CH2OH plus CH3OH. Here the bond breaks up. Hydrogen, same. But when I use sodium in presence of alcohol, the products are same. The products are same. So please note it down. Next, using Dibol H as a suitable reducing agent. What is meant by Dibol H? It is diisobutyl aluminium hydride. It is highly specific in nature. It is highly specific in nature. Means highly specific as well as selective reducing agent. It does not reduce double bonds. It does not reduce double bonds. It does not reduce triple bonds. It does not reduce halogen alone. It does not reduce ether, it does not reduce nitro groups. When aldehydes, esters, nitriles are anhydrides and treated with Dibol H, diisobutyl aluminium hydride, at very low temperature, that is minus 78 degrees Celsius. At very low temperature, minus 78 degrees Celsius, these compounds are get converted into respective aldehydes. And then the respective aldehydes are subjected to reduction with lithium aluminium hydride, we get the respective alcohols. We get the respective alcohols. are obtained, aldehydes and ketones again are treated with a Dibol H at very low temperature, again at minus 78 degrees Celsius. These aldehydes and ketones are get converted into alcohols. Acid halides, ester, nitriles and anhydrides can be converted into aldehydes by using this suitable reducing agent at very low temperature. The obtained aldehydes are ketones and treated with very low temperature with the same reducing agent, we get the respective alcohol. Dibol H can act as a lithium aluminium hydride or at NTP conditions or above it. This compound acts as a reducing agent like lithium aluminium hydride at only at normal room temperature and pressure or above it conditions. For example, aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids or esters are treated with Dibol H at high temperature or above the room temperature. Respective alcohols are obtained. This plays very, very important role in your future level concepts. Next, coming to preparations of alcohols by using Grignard reagent. I took formaldehyde. You know that what is the meaning of Grignard reagent? In haloalkanes, I taught. Alkyl magnesium halides are called as Grignard reagent. I'll take like this CH3MgBr. Magnesium electropositive metal carbon acts as nucleophile. So these electrons will come here. It carries negative charge and it carbon carries positive charge. Therefore, this carbon atoms attacks this one and this magnesium attacks this oxygen to form an intermediate compound. HCOMgBrCH3Hydrogen, which on subjected to hydrolysis, here the bond breaks up. So delta minus, delta plus, this H plus ion attacks this one. And this OH minus ion, this one, so we get the compound like this, CH3CH2OH plus MgOHBr, means we get primary alcohol. When formaldehyde and treated with the Grignard reagent followed by acid hydrolysis, we get the respective primary alcohol. If I take one more molecule, CH3C double bond O hydrogen, and treated with Grignard reagent, the name of the molecule is acetaldehyde. When acetaldehyde and treated with methyl magnesium bromide. Magnesium carries positive charge, carbon carries negative charge. Therefore, this electron moves here. It acts as nucleophile and it acts as electrophile. We get the intermediate. CH3COMgBrCH3Hydrogen, which on subjected to acid hydrolysis. We get CH3CH3CH and this is OH, secondary alcohol, CH3CH OH CH3 plus MgOHBr, we get secondary alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol or 2-propanol. When I take the molecule like this, CH3C double bond O CH3 and the name of the molecule is acetone. acetone on treated with the Grignard reagent. Mg plus CH3 minus. Nucleophile attacks this electrophilic carbon atom. Magnesium attacks this oxygen atom. It forms CH3C single bond O MgBr. Again CH3 intermediate we get CH3, which on subjected to hydrolysis in presence of acidic medium. Here the bond breaks up. This H plus ion attacks this oxygen atom to form tertiary alcohol. Plus means when formaldehyde treated with Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis we get primary alcohol. Acetaldehyde untreated with Grignard reagent and followed by hydrolysis we get secondary alcohol. And acetone untreated with Grignard reagent followed by hydrolysis we get tertiary alcohol. In this case you can observe one thing. Compared to the reactant and product, the number of carbon atoms get increases. Means in the reactant, when I compare the total number, of carbon atoms present in the reactants and products is differ by one carbon atom. Please note it down. Acid chlorides and esters. Acid chlorides or esters reacts with the suitable Grignard reagent. Followed by acid hydrolysis. Gives respective alcohols. Either acid chlorides or esters are treated with Grignard reagent followed by acid hydrolysis. Respective alcohols are obtained. With respect to acid chlorides, the name of the acid chloride is acetyl chloride, or it is also called as ethanol chloride. On treated with the Grignard reagent CH3MgBr. Here both the electrons, whatever the electrons present between these two carbon atom, is get attracted towards the chlorine atom because chlorine is more electronegative than oxygen. It drags electron density, so it acts as nucleophile, attacks the electrophilic carbon atom, and this chlorine attacks this magnesium atom to form an intermediate product, that is CH3C double bond O CH3 plus MgBrCl. Now we got the ketone. Again ketone untreated with the Grignard reagent. On subjected to acid hydrolysis, we get secondary alcohol CH3CHOH plus MgOHBr. We get secondary alcohol, we get tertiary alcohol CH3. No, we are using, so this carbon will goes here, it will jumps here. So we get tertiary butyl alcohol is obtained. In this process, acid chlorides, I cannot use formyl chloride HOCl. This component I cannot use. The reason is this component do not exist in nature. Next, coming to this is an ester. The name of the ester is methyl methanoate. When methyl methanoate untreated with the Grignard reagent, again, this electron density which is present between this carbon and oxygen atom completely move towards this oxygen atom only. This carbon carries negative charge, it attacks this carbon atom, and this CH3 group get attack this magnesium to form an intermediate, that is CH3C double bond O CH3 plus MgOCH3Br. Again, it is treated with CH3MgBr and are subjected to acid hydrolysis. We get the same compound, that is tertiary butyl alcohol. I have not written this side, I have written this side, because both the components are same. Tertiary alcohols are obtained. Now if I take on one more ester like this, HCO, methyl methionate. What happens when it is treated with the Grignard reagent? CH3MgBr. I'll write the final product directly, that is CH3CHOH CH3. Secondary alcohols are obtained. Try to write the mechanism by yourself. Okay, understood? Note it down. The next, from aliphatic primary amines. This is ammonia, NH3. It contains total 3 replaceable hydrogen atom. One hydrogen atom is replaced by only one alkyl group. This is alkyl group, not aryl group, alkyl group. Then we get RNH2. This type of amines are called as alkyl amines. In this case, only one hydrogen atom is replaced by one alkyl group. Therefore, these are also called as primary amines. What are primary amines means? Amines in which one hydrogen atom is replaced by only one alkyl, aryl or aralkyl groups are called as primary amines. In this case, R group is considered as alkyl group. Therefore, it is called as alkyl amines. When alkyl amines are NH2, RNH2, and treated with nitrous acid, HNO2, nitrous, write like this, HONO. I'm going to split this one. So this is the reaction mechanism. It breaks like this. What we are getting, the compound. Now this group becomes one. We get the respective alcohols with the liberation of nitrogen as well as water. Means the alcohols is, whatever the alcohols we are getting here, it depends upon the type of R group which is directly bonded to the nitrogen atom. For example, so primary amines are treated with nitrous acid or sodium nitrate in presence of concentrated HCl, primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol is obtained. This concept depends upon the value of R. If I get only straight chain, whenever it is treated with nitrous acid, HNO2, what is the major product? Primary alcohol is obtained with the liberation of nitrogen. With the liberation of nitrogen as well as water plus H2O. Next, coming to, untreated with nitrous acid, HNO2. Now, this is the chain where the secondary carbon atom is bonded to the nitrogen. Therefore, we get secondary alcohol. With the liberation of nitrogen. This is isobutylamine. In this case, tertiary carbon atom is bonded to the nitrogen atom. Therefore, we get tertiary butyl alcohol is obtained with the liberation of nitrogen. Understood? Good. Note it down, please. From oxirines. What are oxirines? These are the organic compounds which have ring structure between two carbon atoms with one oxygen atom. Adjacent carbon atoms are bonded with one oxygen atom to form a ring structure is called as oxirines. When these oxirines are treated with the Grignard reagent, in this case magnesium is highly electropositive metal. This is minus, and this R group always attacks that carbon atom in the oxirine chain which is a less hindrance. It always attacks that carbon atom in the auxiliary end, which is less hindrance. DERANCE, which is less hindrance. Which is less hindrance in nature. So here the both are same. Therefore, if this molecule attacks here, this group will come here. Directly, this magnesium attacks this oxygen atom by forming the molecule like this. CH2, CH2, RO, MgX, which on subjected to acid hydrolysis. Which on subjected to acid hydrolysis, we get the respective primary alcohol. We get the respective primary alcohol. So this is the mechanism involved in the conversion of oxazolines into respective alcohols by using Grignard reagent. In all these cases, we are using ether as a medium. Whenever we are using the Grignard reagent, we should have to use ether medium. If I use water, Grignard reagent does not react with the given reactant molecule, but the halogen part, this magnesium reacts with water to form the respective hydroxide. To avoid that one, whenever we are using the reactions with the Grignard reagent, we should have to use ether medium. Now complete the following reaction. Carbon minus, magnesium plus. As I told you, this alkyl group of Grignard reagent always attacks that carbon atom which is less hindered in nature. This is less hindrance in nature, therefore it attacks here. Therefore this molecules will come here, therefore this will come here. We get the molecule like this. CH3 carbon, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. Now O, MgBr. This on subjected to hydrolysis. This on subjected to hydrolysis. H plus bar H2 acid hydrolysis. What is the molecule we are getting here now? CH3, CH2, OH. CH2, CH3. We get tertiary alcohol is obtained with byproduct. With byproduct. Now complete the following reaction. Negative part, this is positive part. Directly right followed by acid hydrolysis. This negative part will come here. These electrons will come here. And finally, what the molecule we are getting? CH3, CH3H7OH, CH2, CH2, CH3 plus MgOHBr. So this completes the preparation of alcohols. So students, make sure that go through the preparation of alcohols in the video number 2, video number 3 as well as video number 2, video number 4 and become perfect so that it plays a very important role in our objective NEET and KSAT level examination. In the next class, I will start with the chemical properties of alcohols. Then we will move towards phenols and finally I will go towards ethers. I think you have been understood the class today. Please make sure that if you are happy with my class, subscribe, like and share this channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.